some customization. If you're on the Mac, you and me are gonna customize your terminal right now just to make it look a little more readable. If you're on a Windows, I think you're probably fine. Likely it's already black and looks pretty good, but if you get inspired, you might wanna customize it as well. Let me show you what I mean. So for the Mac people, this is generally what your terminal looks like when you open it up, right? We got the command line, the app is the terminal, and the white I think is a little gnarly. So what we can do is if we go to terminal up here in preferences, you'll see that we have some different views that we can make it look like. I tend to like Homebrew. That's what we use here at 1 month. Now, just watch along for 1 second. If I click double click on Homebrew, it'll open up what that's going to look like. See, I think that looks pretty good. So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna click default, okay? And so now my default will always open up as Homebrew. And here's what I mean. If I close this out and then I open up a new window, you'll see now by default, we get Homebrew. And so that's what you wanna do. So click Homebrew and make it default. The next thing that you wanna do, I just gave you a little peace sign. The next thing that you wanna do is I'm gonna change the color of the text from this kind of matrixy green to a white, as well as the bold. I'm gonna make that white. And the cursor, I'm gonna make that white. There's no right or wrong here. This is not gonna, you know, it's really just for readability. But again, the text, the bold text, and the cursor, I like them white. I think it's easier to read, and so that's what I'm gonna do. And finally, the third thing in customization, we chose Homebrew, we changed the colors. The third thing is I'm gonna change my font. What we can do here is I'm going to choose Menlo. And 18. I think it's just a little easier to read and a little bigger text will be nice. So there we go, choosing those two. Closing that, got that done there, and we can see my changes have been affected. I'm gonna close them again and just restart it there. There we go. And now the font is bigger as well. See what I did there? So follow along, get those customizations rolling. Rewatch this video if you need to go through that again. But this is what I'm gonna be using. If you wanna follow along using this, go with it. If you like the white and the way it was, you can also do that. There's really no right or wrong. And so hopefully you're set up and good to go.